Hey, what's happening, guys? Happy Saturday morning to you. I hope you're having a good weekend. I've got some cool things here we're going to take a look at, and then we're going to make a nice little project out of it. All right, first up is this little guy here. And if I zoom in, you should be able to see exactly what it is. This is the Lowland 32 module from Huemos. So this is an ESP32 in this, I don't know what to call it, form factor. It's not the same as the Node Lua form factor, but then again, it's not the same as a Huemos D1 Mini. It's kind of like an Adafruit feather size thing. So anyway, it's got a battery port into it, has a reset button, has a LED on pin 5. In fact, what I really like about this is if you flip it over, it tells you what all the pins are. Here, let me come up even closer. So you can see what all the pins are without having to go to a website and look it up. I like that. That makes me happy. One thing to keep in mind, it doesn't have a pin mark V in, but you can just put your V in right here to the 5-volt pin. And it will work swimmingly. So that is a very nice little ESP32 module. And I'll put a link to where I got it off of eBay down below in case you guys are interested. Secondly, is this little guy right here. And this is just a three relay shield. I find it to be pretty cool. I bought this specifically for use with my touch sensor thermostat projects. We'll have one heating, cooling, dehumidifying, you know, whatever area you want to go in like that. But before I get into that, I thought that I would do a cool little ESP32 project with it. And hope you guys will enjoy it. Now, I'm going to bring this up here where you can see it better. If it'll focus, there we go. You can see these big old meaty optocouplers here. What do those guys say? EL817s. Yeah, those are nice heavy duty optocouplers. So you have total separation from your low voltage microcontroller side and your high voltage relay side. And you can see these are nice relays. 10 amp 250 volt AC, 10 amp 30 volt DC. These will handle what you need. And then we have the pins here. We have channel 1, 2, 3, ground, VCC, and R ground. I'm not really sure what R ground is, but I have found out that we don't need to use it. So I'm not going to worry too much about R ground in this case. All right, so what I figured we could put together here. Well, first, let me show you the connections for this, so that we're all good and copacetic here. I'm just going to put on 5 of these DuPont cables. Remember, I said we don't really need that last R ground pin there. Okay, so I just need to look here. VCC is black and this brown color is ground. So, all right, ground, VCC. Let's power it up. Okay. We can zoom in here a little bit so you guys can get a better look at what's going on. And then if I take one of the channel pins and touch it to 5 volts, see the LED went on? And if we listen, you can hear it cycling on and off. So all we need to do is put any one of these up to 5 volts. And we can cycle them on and off, no problem, right? All right, let's zoom out here a little bit. And we'll bring in the ESP32. Okay, so we got that guy in there now. I don't know why I unplugged my ground and VCC, if I even did. Okay, so once again, VCC is black. Then we're just going to plug in here. I think that says pin 5. Hope so. To 5, 13, and 12. And let's go put some code in this to control this little device from the web. Alrighty, here's the sketch for the ESP32 house automation using that triple relay shield from IC Station, but you can do it with individual relays or anything you want. So the only library we need is the Wi-Fi library. Then you're going to need to put in your SSID and your password. No, these are not mine. But bonus points, if you know what that refers to, without using Google. Then we're going to start our Wi-Fi server. We're going to call it server on port 80. Now our setup, we have a serial begin at 115.200. And we're going to set our 3 pins for output. If you forget to do that, it won't work. Then we're going to do a delay for those pins to set up, and we'll connect to the network. Wi-Fi begin with the SSID and password that we specified above. Once it's connected, we'll jump out of this, and it will serial print Wi-Fi connected IP address, and then it will print your local IP address. That's what you're going to need to put into your phone. That's going to work if you're inside your house within the range of your Wi-Fi. If you want to do this from outside your house, which I mean is totally the point, you're going to need your external Wi-Fi address, which you can get from your router, and you're probably going to have to set up a DMZ to that device. But I'm not going into that. All right, server begin. We create an integer variable called value and set it for 0. And we begin our loop. We say Wi-Fi client, client equals server available. So it's just listening to see when somebody connects to it. Now if client, and that means if client is true, 1, high, you know, it's the whole Boolean thing, then we're going to serial print new client, client connected, client available. And here's what we're going to do. We are going to read character C from the client. So we're going to see what they click. Then we'll print that out. If C equals N, new line, then we'll skip down and current length will be 0. And here's where we'll begin printing out our Wi-Fi, our Wi-Fi page. Sorry about the ding. That was my son texting me asking me if he can stay out late. All right, Wi-Fi headers, blah, blah, blah. And here's where we have our print. So we say client print, and then click, and then we make this a link, the ahref here, turns kitchen on, here, turns kitchen off. I mean, I just named these arbitrarily. You can call them whatever you want. But here's the point. Each one has to have a specific letter, because this is what is going to get fed back into the program. And then we'll have a blank line, we'll get out of the loop. So now the program is just going to say if current line ends with get H, then that means write pin 5 high. If it ends with get L, low. And it's the same for all of these. That's the end. Close the connection, serial print, client disconnected, end the loop, end that loop. That's it, Fort Pitt, it's over. Pretty simple, huh? I surprised even myself with how simple this one is. All right, let's go check it out. All righty, I got rid of this. Really wasn't necessary for this part of the program. Let's bring in the phone and I'll bunch that up a bit so you guys can see better. I'll turn that off. Okay, so you can see we have everything set up here. So say for instance we want to turn the back door light on, click here to turn back door on, and you see the LED for the back door is turned on. Then we turn back door off. I'm not a web programmer, so just forgive me for this. Walkway on, walkway off, and kitchen on. Yeah, you guys, I don't know if you can see that right there. Yeah. Damn wires in the way. There you go. Kitchen on. These DuPont cables suck. And kitchen. Nope, I hit the wrong button. Kitchen off. So, there you have it. Again, forgive my poor web programming skills. But you now have a working example of how you can control three separate things in your house, all from Wi-Fi, from your phone, from anywhere. I think it's cool. I hope you do too. If you do, give me a thumbs up. Feel free to comment, share, and don't forget to subscribe. Once again, I'll put links to these two items in the down below. All right. I'm out. Peace.